Welcome back to Anime and Beyond. Today we're going to watch episode 1 of the new season of Fire Force. I'm hoping there's a recap, to be honest, of the first season because I forgot how it ended. I believe it was between the it had something to do with the fight between Shinra and Captain Burns. Yeah, he was like testing his power.
Yeah, that dude went.
Yeah, he went ham. He went ham.
Yeah, he was cool.
But yeah, I saw this coming out and I was like, dude, we got to review. We got to check this out. So we're going to get right into it right now. Man, Fire Force came back faster than Haikyuu and all the other animes.
Dr. Stone.
Yeah. It's like, what's up with that?
One thing that's different for this anime to a lot of other animes to me is that there's a lot of scenes where there's no music in the background. And you just hear the noise that's in the area.
Which is kind of a not too, such a bad thing.
Yeah.
What the heck?
Her eye, did you see her tears?
Yeah.
It's like mucus coming from her eyes.
Yeah, everybody's calm and peaceful.
Oh.
Yeah, he's dealing with some PTSD. That'd be funny.
Yeah.
Dude, he's always so serious. What's up with this guy? Yeah, y'all go buy him something. Hook him up. What the heck? Who would ever want to wear that?
Now she looks like a dog with her ear, with her hair. Looks like ears. These people are the wrong people to be dressing Lieutenant.
Seriously. Where's Arthur at, man? Where's...
Oh, here we go. I was waiting for an Infernal.
The show just started too, man.
There goes Shinra. He's going to have to buy a new pair of kicks.
Well, those were the 20th pair.
So like that is something that should be a write-off.
The next time you're buying your own.
Yeah. Man, this must be a big one. Whoa. Okay.
There you go. Have you seen this before?
No. Ground was shaking. Is it in the air?
Oh, I thought it teleported. Where did that thing come from? That's an interesting inferno. Wow. He said, get that out of here. Bro, low-key, you should be dead, bro. Good. That thing's kind of creepy, though.
Hey, there's Arthur.
Hey, the intro, though.
Ooh. That was cool.
Yeah, now they're starting to roll up. That ain't going to do nothing.
There we go. Squad up. Man, they got dressed up quick.
I know. Seriously. Did y'all bring Shinra's?
He looks way too happy to do his job.
He looks a little creepy.
Him too. Okay. Captain Ovi. Dude, that guy is just... He's the goat. They better not say Infernals merge together. And there's multiple. There better not be multiple cores.
If that's so, that means they're getting smarter and smarter. Oh my goodness. Oh gosh.
It's like a spear bomb.
You know what that reminds me of? Naruto. QB.
That's what, yeah. Hey, tag team.
Nice. Hey. All right, Arthur. I see you. He got dressed up.
That's what I said.
Dude, this is a boss battle, bro. If this is a game, it's going to be a boss battle.
Yeah, and if this guy's in episode 1, then what's in the season finale?
It's always up to him, though. Oh.
Got him. Man doesn't miss.
Nikomata.
The cat was in the kanji. Oh, I didn't know she could do that.
What in the heck?
Gorilla Cyclops.
Sir Arthur. Dang. They all have names for their moves now.
Dang. That did nothing.
Yeah, seriously. Oh, I was about to say.
Captain and OB America right there.
Rapid man kick. All these special moves. Maybe they always had this.
Latum.
Hey, I like that. Latum.
What?
Oh, they picked him up. They picked that up for him. Why did they think that was a good idea?
Oh, my goodness. They're going to blame Shinra. Oh.
They know. Well, he knows. He's going to take the rep.
He's thinking about it. I think they're just going to put the blame on him. They're not even going to wait. That, yeah. I told you. I knew it. Dude, they're savage, man. They don't mess around.
Man. Damn dirty.
Man's fight. What?
Oh, no.
Overindulgent pecs.
What is going on?
It was just them two.
What? What the heck? What the heck?
Dang, he's swole.
What the
heck? He did not look that swole.
What the heck? What is happening right now?
It's definitely a very lighthearted episode.
Power Cobra. Stupid. It is received by females. So beginning, man, straight up, it just went straight to the fighting scene. It just went straight to action. And they fought that big little giant, what would you call it?
Inferno.
Yeah. And, you know, you see everybody's roles again. You know, so it wasn't necessarily a recap, but I didn't know the names. So they kind of helped, you know.
Oh, their moves?
No, the names. They actually mentioned their names.
Oh, okay.
Like Maki. So, like, I know who's who. Like you were saying earlier, there's Maki and there's Tamaki. You know, we can get mixed up. I think it was cool to see how Company 8 had a coordinated attack where everybody had like a role that they had, and they would, you know, knock out every single core that they had so they could take it down. At first the enemy looked kind of, you know, formidable, but then they just kind of knocked them out of the park, and it was just easy KO, you know.
Yeah, I one thing that you see a lot with shows, it will be like there's a villain and then or a bad guy. And then as the show goes on, you realize that bad guy is just a small piece of the bigger picture, mm-hmm. small piece of the puzzle. And so with last year, when we finally met it was the Infernals first, and then we got introduced to the Evangelist group. And so now, like, the Infernals don't seem like too big of a deal.
Yeah.
But making them bigger could cause issues. Like, if they can combine, or, I mean, maybe multiple people turn into an Infernal as once. Mm-hmm. I don't know. But I think it's cool that they changed it, and that there's, like, more risk now, even though they took him out so easily.
Yeah,
which is really good.
Well, remember last season the Ephemeris were starting to get smarter, and so this is like, you know, they're starting to, it seems like now they're starting to get even smaller and create like even bigger.
Yeah,
and you, like you said, who knows what's gonna happen towards the end.
Yeah, there was at least one of them that was talking.
Yeah, there was talking. Yeah,
so it's almost like abnormals in like Attack on Titan or something. Yeah. Like that,
or Nomu.
Or no, that's true. The calendar at the end was just weird. They're getting way too hyped up for that calendar to be last place.
I don't know what was up with that. I wasn't really following that. It all started with them shopping, and
yeah,
they, oh man,
why did they do the lieutenant like that? Yeah, that was dirty.
That was dirty.
He has such bad fashion sense that he actually wore it, even though it was like, I don't know.
He does seem like the too tense type, like he's too uptight, and he kind of just I don't know. But in another sense, I feel like he's kind of relatable, because he's like, in my opinion, I don't care,
as long as it's comfortable. I'll wear it.
There you go. As long as it's comfortable. That's me. But anyway, we're gonna get on to episode 2, so let's get it.
He's so much cooler than them. That guy just needs to stop talking. What is this guy doing?
He seems a little too old to.
I really don't trust anybody in the Fire Force world. Look, he already looks like a villain.
Just like the media, man. Can't trust it. Are they gonna spar or what? Bro, yeah, I don't
You
trust
jump
this guy.
Back.
Boy, if someone came up to me like... Bro, this dude, I'd burn you. I'd just like, yeet.
The heck?
What the heck?
Have we heard this girl's voice before?
I don't think so.
I don't remember.
I don't remember. No. Yeah. Is someone like... talking to him in his mind, like infiltrating his mind, or what?
I know they said like all of the Adola bursts are kind of like connected, so it could be that she could be the girl with the crown on her face. Why does he keep asking? Yeah,
dude, what is happening? What is whoa, what?
They're under control.
I'd go crazy if I was him. I'd be like, I don't know what's happening. What the
he
heck?
He was smelling it.
So stupid.
This is serious, dude. Quit smelling on his foot.
Ooh. Dude, what happened to Shinra? What the heck?
I wonder if that voice is haunting him, because he knew... I think it was her.
Oh, so she's mad. Wow, he can handle himself. What the?
Now he kind of seems like Naruto when he gets that...
Kyuubi form. Yeah.
Yeah, before. Just a few tales. The first pillar. I wonder if I've heard that before.
So stupid. This is so weird. Wow, they knew? How did they know, though?
Oh, he can even use that now?
Wow. Good grief.
So he's not being fully controlled, because otherwise she wouldn't know how to do that, I don't think. Why does he always have to turn it into this?
Hey, he looks like he's strapped. He's like, hey, let's go.
Oh, Arthur, hey. He's using him as a shield, and he likes it.
What the heck? I don't know what to do. Like, I don't know. I don't know what to say. Oh, I got you.
That makes sense.
Loud and clear.
Wait, what happened to his family? Dang, that's sad. His dad didn't seem like that kind of person,
though. Yeah. Maybe there's more to a story that he's not saying.
Dude, how is he going to break out of this?
No, seriously.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Dang. Dude, that would have fractured his skull. Man, this girl's gonna be dangerous. So she's...
Yeah, that's weird.
Okay.
Wait a minute. Dang, that's kind of... Man, I gotta say this. First of all, that old man There you go. See, what more do we got to say?
Hey, he loves pain, man. He loves pain.
You know what it reminds me of?
Who?
Hisoka.
I can see that.
And you know, but you know why?
Yeah.
Right?
The gun.
Yeah.
The gun.
Yeah. He was like, he craved. But it's, man, this dude just had me cringing the whole time. Like, I didn't know what to think. Like, I was like,
yeah, it's like that awkward smile that you're like, it's kind of funny, but it's kind of like, what the heck?
Yeah, it's like, should I laugh at this or should I just be creeped out? I don't know. Yeah. But
yeah, he jumped right, and the guy like popped.
Well, when forward. I was about to run up on me like that. No. But anyway, that was interesting. But what I'm mostly concerned is the whole idea of a Dola burst and the link. At the end, it sounded like she wasn't. The girl that was talking to Shinra, that she wasn't the one that had a Dola Bush, but she was mentioning someone that did, or maybe she was the one, and she's talking about another person. If that's true, is it like a family thing? Like, okay, you have it and your brother has it, or in this sense, if she's a sister, or she's a girl, so does she have a sister that has a Dola Bush or something? I don't know. I don't know how it works. I honestly don't understand it. To be honest, that's what I got, that she was trying, and that's why he got kind of, I don't know, man.
So like,
she possessed Shinra temporarily, and that's why he turned into like a demon, because he got into his head about his mom. But the thing is, I don't like she. For how would she know that?
So
I don't know.
I think this might be the first time. This is the first time I remember hearing Shinra being called like a pillar, like the people with the Dola burst being called pillars. But I mean, if we go back and look at that, one of the guys from, I think it was Company 4, I don't know, where he was grabbing kids and like using that bug to test to see if they would turn into people like Shinra and his brother. So I think the Adola, if I remember correctly, the Adola burst is when like you're like a match. Otherwise, if you get bit, you turn into an inferno.
Yeah.
But like if it's a match, then you're an Adola burst, and somehow they're linked because Sho and they're able to go like kind of like view that world, and also, you know, Sho was able to talk to Shinra in that world kind of
stuff. Yeah, that's what I kind of assumed.
And then also this girl, now obviously it looks like that was Iris, but she was this girl was called the first pillar by somebody from the Evangelist, and so she's must be like the queen or the best person of using a Dola burst, because she was able to literally control Shinra.
And
it looks like there's another person. Well, the trailer mentioned how there was going to be another person with the Dola burst, and so I think that's who she was talking about at the end.
So what do you make of the people that were controlled?
She was controlling them too.
Them too?
But that might...
So then I guess with Adola Burst, maybe Shinra doesn't know that. So you can control anybody at your leisure if you want.
That's farther than I knew. I didn't even think anybody was going to be able to control Shinra, but she was able to, looks like maybe not so much control them, but take advantage of their rage. Because that guy, he had like a healthy rivalry probably with Shinra.
Yeah.
But because of what just happened, he got really angry.
Yeah.
And then Shinra got really angry too, because he was saying, she kept feeding him these lies in his head, like your mother's dead or whatever she was saying, like, oh yeah, you're trying to save your brother, and then you find out the person who destroyed your house or whatever was your mother, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
The person you hated for so long.
See, I always thought it was her anger that was in Shinra, and then she was using his experience to fuel that anger in him, and so that like her anger kind of passed on through his experience, and that's why he got mad.
I think it could be that too, because Shinra, I think at one point said like, "Why are you so mad? Why is there so much hate in you?"
Yeah.
So it could be that like she's the one who's mad. She's the one who just wants to cause chaos, and then she said she had a secret about Shinra's mom too.
See, that's the one.
And that's the thing. Sho was still alive. So
he would have to have met her, though.
And this could be like a Demon Slayer thing. Can you turn Infernals back to humans? Like, is that possible? Like, I don't know.
That's true. We haven't, yeah.
Because maybe that would be something. Because it looks like from season one that she turned into that like infernal demon monster with the horns and everything. So if she's somehow still alive and they can turn her back, then...
Yeah, this is so interesting. And then the whole And then you got to think about Sho, like, what about him? Like, I don't know, man. And then the girl with the crown, like, I know she has something to do with it.
Yeah, she said she came to check on him, but then she saw that the first pillar was going on a rampage, so.
Oh, man, it's all just, like, I don't know what the word is, but it's, episode two seemed to, just explode to me. It's like all this stuff has happened.
Yeah.
You know, you have the old man going crazy. Adora! Adora! You have the whole thing with Odola Link. You have these new characters being introduced, like Girl with a Crown, and then all the backstory and things.
Do you think that this first pillar lady, kind of controlling Shinra to react the way he was reacting, do you think she's with the Evangelist, or she's like totally on her own?
Ooh, that's a great question. I think she's on her own. The way she was acting, I take that back. Evangelist. I think probably Evangelist, but
my thing is, because if she's the first, if they're calling her the first pillar, then, and she's got this Odola Link, how come she's not in charge and Sho is? Like, Sho is kind of like the leader.
She is rogue.
So, I don't know. That's true. I don't know. I think we just have to see more about it.
Yeah, maybe she is rogue. Because then, my thinking is, why would she need to? If she's the first pillar, then she, like, why does she need,
She might not even be, for all I know, she might not even be human. She might just be, like, someone who's, like, living through this Odola Link somehow. And like not even like actually existing anymore. Maybe this is like the afterlife that they're connected to, and that's why Sho Mom's still alive, because he can talk to her through that. I don't know. The Odola Link, it could be, I don't know. That could be anything.
I was thinking that old man might know something, because he came up to Shinra acting like, you know, like, show me, you know, show me. But I was thinking, like, maybe he's doing that to get a hint at someone like this. Like,
yeah.
Get a hint of, like, what exactly is Odola Link. Get more information.
And it did seem like he knew what was going on with Shinra, because he said, he's like, are you seeing someone talking to you that looks like someone you know?
Mm-hmm.
And she did look like someone who knows.
Yeah.
So it might be something like that.
Yeah. Maybe he's kind of just playing it off.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of.
Arthur's backstory. Like, the whole time, I thought Arthur was, like, you know, this stupid dude that was, like, a joke, you know, comedic relief. But that's like it kind of seemed like a pretty sad backstory. And then why his parents disappeared, like, that was not explained. But, like, imagining, going through and imagining stuff so that way your life doesn't feel as sad, you don't feel as hungry, and everything seems better.
Yeah, you know how what is the memory where you block out certain memories that are really, that really affect you? Maybe something like that happened to him. And really, it's like a totally different story where, like, his parents were turned to infernos or something like that.
Yeah, he could have wrote that note to himself.
Yeah, or something. I don't know.
But I gotta say, I don't remember Arthur being that good. Like, on a competition with Shinra?
He went beast mode. Yeah.
Dude, he was legit. Like, when he just blocked kick, that was pretty cool. My favorite scene from Shinra last season was when he was fighting with the sword the whole time. And then he's like, wait, I'm right-handed. And then he switches it, and he was like, oh, there's my power, because he was, like, weak before. And so, I mean, but when he gets serious, they say, when he gets serious, he gets strong.
I know. Yeah, exactly.
It's like the deeper he is into his delusion.
Well, literally, like, his backstory, he believed that he was a knight.
Mm-hmm.
Or, I guess, a
king knight.
King,
he's
yeah.
He's royalty.
He's a royalty. But, you know what? All heroes always have a tragic past.
Yeah. True.
And that's anime.
And then also Shinra knocking himself back.
Oh yeah.
Dude, yeah. That was pretty dope.
That was crazy. He should be out cold.
Yeah, broken nose, up. Cracked forehead.
I mean, you gotta do what you gotta do though. Yay. Mm-hmm. Hey, props to him. Thank y'all for watching and supporting our channel. Don't forget to check out our social media accounts. Don't forget to like, subscribe, leave a comment down below. Let us know what you think about this episode reaction and reviews.
And you can find us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok. Devin's streaming on YouTube for games. And if you like us, please follow our friends on YouTube as well. Jay Frizzle, Clammy, and Bloxton for gaming. Rich Aladdin for short films. Teray today for vlogs. And then OrcTech08 for sermons.
That said, I'm Devin.
I'm Noah.
And we'll see y'all next time.
Peace.